my recording stopped, so I'm going to go back to 1C and redo this problem that we had started. And we said the first fraction, we need a factor of a y plus 1 and a y plus 1 to get a common denominator. And then the second term, we needed an x minus 2 and x minus 2 to get a common denominator. So now we can combine numerators, 8 times 5 plus 1, plus 4 times x minus 2, over this now matching denominator. There's no reason to multiply the denominators together. In fact, that's usually not helpful. So now let's simplify our numerator, 8y plus 8 plus 4x minus 2. X minus 2 times y plus 1, and our 8 is going to cancel, so I have 8y plus 4x over x minus 2, y plus 1. If you're asked to give your answer in factor form, then you factor out the common factor of 4, so I have 2y plus x over the denominator. Okay, then the next example, we have a trinomial denominator, so we should factor this trinomial denominator so we can see what the least common multiple is. And I see that I want a positive 2 in the middle, so I'm going to use the factors of 5 and 3 for 15, and I have plus 5 and minus 3. Okay, my first denominator doesn't need anything additional. My second denominator is missing a factor of an x minus 3. So I need to multiply the numerator and the denominator by x minus 3. So I can combine the numerator over this common denominator. You can build up by the denominator back together in case you find a matching factor in the numerator. So I'm going to have 7 minus 3x plus 9 over x plus 5 and plus minus 3, and that will be 16 minus 3x over the denominator. Okay, so the next topic in this worksheet is simplifying complex rational expressions. And a complex fraction, or a complex rational expression, is called that because it has more than one fraction bar in the problem. So you can see we have a fraction bar here, a fraction bar here, and a fraction bar here. So this is called a complex fraction, a complex rational expression. So there's two different strategies for solving these problems. My preferred one is to look for any denominators in the numerator and denominator, and then multiply by any denominators you see in the top and the bottom of what I call a cleverly chosen version of 1. So then remember that you need to distribute this x, both of the two terms in the numerator, to get 8x plus 1, and both of the two terms in the denominator to get 4x minus 1. So that would be your final answer for this strategy. And the other way some people like to do it is to work on the numerator separately. You get a common denominator for the numerator. So you multiply 8 by x over x. You get 8x plus 1 over x. Then you could work on the denominator separately and have 4 minus 1 over x. And then you would need to get a common denominator for these two guys, so you could combine them. then you need to do the numerator divided by the denominator. So you have 8x plus 1 over x divided by 4x minus 1 over x. And then dividing by a fraction means multiply by the reciprocal. So we're going to multiply by x over 4x minus 1. These guys cancel, and we get the same answer of 3 minutes. So it just depends on which way you like better. I suggest you pick one and stick with it. I prefer the multiply by the denominator I see way, because I just find that often has fewer steps. Okay, so let's look at B. And I'm going to do B by noticing that in the denominator, I have a denominator of x minus 2. So I'm going to multiply numerator and denominator by x minus 2. And I'm going to keep the numerator factored for it, just in case I come upon a common factor with the denominator. So now I'm going to distribute x minus 2 to x. Minus, and then when I multiply the 3 over x minus 2, times x minus 2, is x minus 2 15. Okay, so now I'm going to have x minus 3 times x minus 2 over x squared minus 2x minus 3. And I could see if I can factor the denominator, because now that you know how to factor, you should just looking hard for every possible opportunity to factor. So factoring often makes your life easier. So I have a trinomial here, and 3 and 1 are the only choices for the lasts. And if I do minus 3 and plus 1, it looks to me like that works. So then I have matching factors in numerator and denominator, so those can cancel. And this looks a lot simpler to me. So what we're saying is if you plug in the value for x to that original quantity, you get the same thing as if you plug x into this much simpler version. Okay, so then C, you're seeing a denominator of an x minus 2 and an x squared minus 4, but I know that factors as x minus 2 x plus 2. So they have a common denominator to be made from the x plus 2, x minus 2. So I'm going to multiply by chosen value of 1, so that I haven't changed anything. All is usual to multiply by 1. Okay, so I'm going to take this quantity that I'm multiplying by and distribute it. So the x minus 2 will cancel, and the x times x plus plus x plus 2 times x minus 2 over, and now again I need to distribute the denominator, and the number I'm multiplying by will cancel completely, plus x plus 2 x minus 2. Okay, no canceling can go on at this point because of the plus. Things have to be multiplied in order to have any ways of canceling. So let's see if we can simplify. We'll have x squared plus 2x plus x squared minus 4 over 3 plus x squared minus 4. So that's going to give us 2x squared plus 2x factor of c in the numerator, so minus c times x squared plus x minus 2 over x squared minus 1. So let's do a bit of factoring can happen. And you make two binomials that multiply together. You have a 2 and a 1, and a plus and a minus. And then an x plus 1 and an x minus 1. So then we have to cancel and factor. And we have 2 times x plus 2 over x plus 1. And this will be your final answer. And that's all the examples I have.